Today on Warrior Update, Girls Swim heads to state, Waubonsie honors veterans, and we visit a turkey farm. It's Friday, November 17th. I'm Karina Collins, and this is Warrior Update. Waubonsie honored veterans last week. Wase Muzaffar reports.
Last week, Waubonsie Valley honored our country's veterans at its annual assembly. The event included presentations, guest speakers, and an address from Korean conflict veteran Lou Kelso. The day included educational breakout sessions from various veterans and their families. Some of this year's students have enlisted and will be serving next year.
What motivated me the most was I'm very patriotic, so it was one of those things that I was like, that I can give back to my country. I've had a long history of people serving in my family up like World War II up to Vietnam. It stopped at my dad.
It's been a while that I've wanted to serve. I've had a few times that I thought that I wanted to like join the Army because of programs that was in it, but then I thought really the Navy was the best way that I wanted to go. It's something that like I really grew up with. My dad, my sister, my brother, even my grandparents, they've been in.
My family, including my sister and brother who've been in, they wanted me to do a job that was going to help me in life afterwards. It was definitely a deciding factor as to what I was gonna do. If I could not get into the Navy, I was probably just gonna go to a trade school.
Veterans Day originally was to celebrate and remember the dead from World War I. It was Armistice Day originally on the day that World War I treaty was signed. Later, it was converted into Veterans Day to honor all veterans, and we've been remembering that ever since to honor those veterans, men and women that have fought for us, for our freedom, for our independence.
For Warrior Update, I'm Wasim Muzaffar.
High school students take CTE courses off campus. Warrior Update reports.
Career and technical fields are growing, and a place in Addison helps high school students prepare for that future.
Technology Center of DuPage is the supersized elective. It's a career and technical education environment for all of DuPage County and Lyons Township students. Gives students the opportunity for a career and technical education experience, college and career preparation.
Opened in 1974, TCD provides education for health science, law and public safety, manufacturing, STEM, and more.
There's an economic benefit because for each credit hour at COD is $135. We have some students who are earning upwards of 20, 30 credits here, and when you multiply that times $135, you're saving upwards of $3,000 or so dollars.
In addition, the programs offer dual college credit, which goes toward the College of DuPage, Kishwaukee College, and Joliet Junior College.
All of our courses do offer dual credit. Many of the courses require a student to test through COD, through the AccuPlacer, to qualify for dual credit. 77% of our students this year are in dual credit courses during the school day.
For more information, visit tcddupage.org. For Warrior Update, I'm Maddie Pennington.
It's the busiest place around this time of year. Warrior Update has more.
Around Thanksgiving time, thoughts turn to the dinner table and turkey. But there's a long process that gets that turkey to the grocery store. Undesser Turkey Farm is locally owned in Bristol, Illinois. The farm started at the corner of Liberty and Eola in Aurora over 40 years ago and continued to grow from there.
In 1972, I had them for pets for the kids. There were 25 of them in our backyard. And when Thanksgiving came, we came in this building and butchered them. And I gave one to each of our friends that were here. And then it went to 100, then it went to 1,000. And then at one time it was 5,000.
The baby turkeys are shipped in from Michigan around April and raised throughout the summer until November.
We raise them from the time that they're born. They start out in a room called a brooding room, and then they go from there to the barn, and then they go from there to another stage barn.
And feed them special meal so that they can get a good start. They don't get antibiotics or hormones the whole time through, so they're all natural.
That's what happens to them until they get to the part where they're going to go to the slaughterhouse, which we also do here. People start calling us the first part of October. The Sunday before Thanksgiving is when the people start coming to pick up their turkey. We even had people call us on Thanksgiving morning to pick up a fresh turkey.
For Warrior Update, I'm Courtney Henderson.
On our mission to find a turkey, but we might have to leave the turkey and run because it's in the case. Ham. These are turkeys, right? Or are those turkeys? Tender, juicy, young turkey. It's young and it's ready to bowl. Our plan is we're gonna go bowling with the turkey. I don't know what to bowl with. Dinosaurs? So now we're gonna get our pins and we're gonna grab. Now this is turkey bowling, so we don't need that many. We're gonna set our... I gotta get warmed up. We only got to do one set before this dude yelled at us. So if there's a lesson to be learned, don't go bowling in Yorkville with turkeys.
Girls swimming heads to state this weekend. Warrior Update has more.
State competition opens this weekend, and the Warriors are hoping to improve on last year's performance. Two individuals and three relay teams advanced from sectionals last weekend.
I think the strongest aspect of the team is our relays, probably, just because we've all been competing so much to see who's going to get that spot on the relay.
Each swimmer has come into this season being able to swim many different events, so we all had to work really hard and prove ourselves.
Coming into sectionals, we had so many different girls who could swim so many different events, which was really just made the team stronger as a whole.
The team has been close this year, which has helped contribute to their success.
We work together to find our strengths and to succeed in the end.
I feel like we've been very welcoming. We had a lot of freshmen on the team, so that was really fun. And I feel overall all the levels of the swim team have been very connected this year.
This year I think everyone has been really close together, which has been fun to see. Coming in for morning practice and getting ready with everyone, and then once we get toward the end of the season, we typically get in the water really late and we just sit and talk for a long time, and that's always just really fun to do. We had some really great performances at sectionals, and knowing that they're going to come in even a better position for state is going to be exciting.
We're really excited that all the relays made it again this year, so I can't wait to see how fast the girls swim.
For Warrior Update, I'm Olivia Macris.
What do you typically eat for Thanksgiving dinner?
I eat chicken and spaghetti.
That is wonderful.
I'll be damned if I go home with a wild turkey like you.
I've lived in Naperville for about like 18 years, and I've never experienced having someone try to kill me. So I feel like this environment is really open-minded and like welcome to turkeys. What do you typically eat for your Thanksgiving dinner?
We typically have turkey and all the fixings. Sometimes we'll throw a ham on the side, maybe even a prime rib.
You know, I feel like a lot of people are wondering like why a turkey is running loose in the school. But it's like the senior prank where like they want to put like three pigs out and like then label them 1, 2, and 4, but it's just like one turkey and it's me. What do you guys usually eat for Thanksgiving?
Chicken.
You I fully endorse that, absolutely. What do you typically eat for Thanksgiving?
Turkey.
But I heard that steak and like a rotisserie chicken is like really popular now for Thanksgiving meals. So yeah, I heard it's really big. So
you know what? I'm gonna stick with the turkey.
Yeah.
All right.
Turkey. Some stuffing.
Well, I heard that Vincent doesn't even like turkey.
I do like turkey.
Are you sure? So typically, what do you eat for Thanksgiving?
Let's put it in a song, guys.
I got greens, beans, potatoes, tomatoes, lamb, ribs, all those. Greens, beans, potatoes, tomatoes, chicken, turkey, red, you name it!
This is really good.
We usually go with turkey and cranberries and stuffing and mashed potatoes. My mom makes a mean mashed potatoes.
So how would you feel about subtracting the element of turkey and replacing it with, say, tuna or some other form of meat?
I would certainly be open to it.
Because turkeys are animals, so if you like them, why would you eat them?
Because they taste good.
That's a fair point. Okay, thank you.
That's all for Warrior Update. I'm Karina Collins. Thanks for watching. That's all for watching. Oh my God.
That's all.
Wabanzi honored veterans last week. Wasafe Muzaffar. Wasafe. There's no F in his name. Reports. I don't hear a difference. What did the turkey say to the computer? Google.